Good morning, and welcome to this workshop on strengthening the standards and guidance process for personal protective equipment and personal protective technology for a more resilient and effective public health supply chain, and therefore better public health. My name is Linda Hawes Clever, and I chair the workshop planning committee. The workshop is sponsored by NIOSH, and NIOSH's NPPTL, the National Personal Protective Technology Laboratory. One of the many responses to the COVID-19 pandemic was taken by the federal government, was to develop a strategy aimed at facilitating a coordinated effort between the government and American industry to build a better public health supply chain and increase its resiliency. This is because every life is precious. Thousands of nurses and doctors and first responders, frontline servers and others died when COVID happened because they did not have personal protective equipment and technology. Their lives were precious. And we must prevent that kind of tragedy in the future. The National Strategy for a Resilient Public Health Supply Chain outlines this vision through a series of more than 30 goals or plans of action and milestones, POAMs. One of these goals was to launch a task force of experts who can take their work to improve the PPE and PPT standards and the supply chain systems. Over the last year, this product standardization task force, or simply we'll call it the task force, has convened numerous times and has identified multiple gaps in PPE and PPT standards and related supply chain systems. A report of these efforts has been drafted and will be released within the next few months. The goal of this two-day workshop is to examine some of the standards gaps identified by the task force and explore innovative approaches and technologies to update and streamline the U.S. standardization systems for PPE and PPT to support supply chain resiliency. The reason we're able to have all this is because of the staff work, which has been absolutely nothing short of miraculous. And I'll name them later, but I'd say that we have all worked through storms, earthquakes, illnesses, and so far no wildfires, but a tremendous effort. And we're delighted that there's a broad span of experts, both on the panels and of course with the moderators, and also who are attending this workshop. And that includes people from all levels of government, academia, industry, private sector, the media, and many others who, and of course, there always are others. At any rate, the goal of this workshop is to identify the gaps, as I said. And in designing the workshop, the planning committee considered a resilient supply chain to be a supply chain that's agile and nimble, capable of absorbing shocks, goodness sakes, we've had them. We'll be looking at the entire supply chain from the design and manufacture through marketing, sales, distribution, all the way to our targets, the users, both in work and in the general public sectors. We have two full days of interesting conversations that will include presentations and panel discussions. Today, we'll kick off the workshop with an additional session, with an initial session, standards, the process it goes through, and the relationship between standards and the supply chain and innovation. Tenor Venema will chair that and will introduce a key graphic that outlines the supply chain and its shocking and tempting gaps. We emphasize along the way access and effectiveness. And of course, we're talking about all of us. Everyone needs to have good PPE and good PPT. because all lives are precious. After that session, there will be another session on the COVID-19 experience with a focus on what we've learned. Following those first two sessions, we'll have about a half hour break. And when we return, we'll step into the supply chain processes, begin with the role of standards in the design of PPE and PPT, and then the impact of standards on manufacturing and on manufacturing capacity. We'll then close out day one. Tomorrow, day two, we'll begin with a conversation about standards and regulatory oversight in conformity, certification, and the continued performance of PPEs and PPTs when they are in use. This will be followed by a session on marketing, stockpiling, and distribution. All of these elements are in this supply chain, and we mean to cover them all. Our last session for the morning tomorrow will examine standards around communication and education so people know how to use this equipment. After a break, we'll come back for an engaging discussion on how we can support the actions and identify the gaps so we can start to get to work. Our final session will be a roundtable discussion among the planning committee members in which we will reflect on the conversations throughout the 2 days and discuss what the ideal PPE and PPT standards systems might look like and how we can bring this really complex system into perspective and all of that into the standardization process so it will serve the supply chain resiliency and therefore will serve all of us. We'll then close the workshop with some words from our sponsor, NPPTL. Although we have a huge agenda and it's fascinating and engaging, the planning committee recognizes that this is a huge topic and we could take many more days. We've had planning meetings to plan the meetings to plan the meetings, and we could plan many more meetings. This agenda cannot and does not cover everything that's related to PPE and PPT supply chain, but we hope it will spark discussion. And far more importantly, we hope that it will spark action. We have a great slate of panelists on our agenda and our audience, and we hope and expect that you will participate now and in the future. There are, again, many different representatives from many different sectors, and that's what we'd wanted. After the workshop, the National Academies will publish a summary that covers the presentations and the discussion for the public use. And we look forward to future smoothly functioning supply chain so that we get what we need, which is a safe workplace and living space in this country. Thank you so much for coming. We'll look forward to continuing on. And now I would like to invite Dr. Mary Ann D'Alessandro, who's the director of NPPTL, to share some of her opening remarks. Thanks so much.
Thank you very much, Linda, and good morning, everyone. And thank you to those serving on the committee and the speakers and panelists for actively participating in this workshop on personal protective equipment and personal protective technology product standardization to address supply chain resiliency. As Linda described, the National Strategy for a Resilient Public Health Supply Chain was published in July 2021, and it identified actions necessary to achieve a resilient public health supply chain for the nation. One of the actions identified in the National Strategy included the need to establish a product standardization task force, as Linda mentioned. To set the stage for this workshop, I will provide a brief overview of the task force to build on Linda's opening, touch on the tasks being addressed by the group, and talk about how this workshop will feed into our next steps. The Product Standardization Task Force is focused on promoting innovative approaches and technologies to streamline PPE and PPT availability, use, and equity. We distinguish between PPT and PPE. PPT includes the PPE worn by individuals, such as respirators, gloves, and protective clothing, and the technical methods, such as fit testing methods, processes, techniques, and tools that support the development and use of the PPE that is worn by individuals. What we learned through the pandemic is that while the current PPE standards are adequate, innovation is needed to catalyze improved availability, use, and equity, not only in the development of new products and standards through innovation, but in standards to address limitations, such as standards to improve fit for all workers and for underserved populations, standards for improved fit testing methods, such as tabletop fit testing to enable rapid fit assessment, and innovative standards to address other supply chain challenges. Innovation and improvements to address the gaps associated with PPT and PPE standards will not solve all of the challenges, but are expected to contribute to improvements in PPE demand outpacing supply. One example is how can standards provide greater assurance that PPE will fit the users? We identified three tasks to address the PPE and PPT standardization gaps. The first task was to create the task force, as Linda mentioned. That was established to bring together key federal and non-governmental partners, including federal agencies, manufacturers, distributors, and labor unions to come together on these issues. The task force was established in March 2022, and we met monthly between March and October 2022. Then members were encouraged to participate in the NIOSH Equitable PPE Protections Workshop, where potential PPE standards gaps associated with PPE equity were identified. Then NIOSH held a Committee on PPE for the Workforce meeting in December 2022, where we focused on the use of all NIOSH-approved air purifying respirators and additional PPE standards issues associated with respirator use in healthcare. The task group prepared an annual report, which is going through clearance at this time, as Linda mentioned, prior to being made to the public. But the draft report was provided to the workshop planning committee to serve as an input to their planning. The second task is to catalog and prioritize the PPE standards issues. This workshop that will be a key component to that data collection and take the information we have gathered so far and summarize it and also see what other gaps we may have missed. The output of this workshop will be assessed by the task force to identify actions that could be taken immediately to address near-term PPE and PPT standardization gaps. The third task involves establishing consensus recommendations that will focus on identifying the actions that need to be taken to address the priorities. There will be touch points throughout the life of the task force to take action to address quick wins and near-term priorities that arise along the way. As I mentioned, the task group consists of participants across many relevant federal agencies. These agencies have provided input to the task group activities and are expected to be involved in digesting the proceedings from this workshop and prioritizing the gaps to identify actions the nation can take to support supply chain resiliency. As the task group falls under the Joint Supply Chain Resiliency Work Group, it provides the opportunity for federal and private sector partners to come together to discuss the priorities, provide recommendations, and establish consensus actions for the nation. This workshop is our final step in cataloging the gaps and beginning that prioritization. The proceedings will be digested by our task group, where we will establish consensus prioritization and actions needed to address the PPE and the PPT standardization gaps. I look forward to the speakers and panelists' input over the next few days to help us achieve these objectives, and I'm happy to take questions in the time remaining if there are any. Thank you.